everyone, welcome to Hedgehog Hollow. So today I'm talking about what Easy Press to buy. So the other day I talked about the Cricut Maker versus the Cricut Air, and so kind of as a follow-up, lots of you asked me about, okay, so that's great, I've chosen what machine I want, I want to make lots of t-shirts and I want to use infusible ink, what size Easy Press do I buy? Now, let's just do a little bit of an introduction to the Easy Press first. What is the Easy Press? So I have all three of them here. These are the Easy Press 2. So they came out with an Easy Press 1 that had a blue insert in here. And the difference between that and the 2 is that it goes to a lower temperature. So the Easy Press 2 goes up to 400 degrees. And the 400 degrees is important if you want to do things like infusible ink. Now, the Easy Press replaces something like that big clamshell press that you see behind me. Now, I do have a clamshell press because some of the things that I do for Hedgehog Hollow and for other work requires that I do need a clamshell press occasionally. But it's big, it's heavy, it's expensive, and it's pretty difficult to store as well because you can't store them open. It damages the springs, closed rather. You have to store them open. They're really heavy to move. They're difficult, all of those kinds of things. So Cricut came up with this great idea called the Easy Press. They come in these three sizes. So you can get the mini. This is kind of the original, the regular size. And this is the large size. So you'll also notice they're in different colors. That doesn't actually make any difference. The red is the raspberry. The pink was a special edition. And this is the mint. So the raspberry and the mint are kind of the ones you get regularly. And this was a light pink special edition. As always, I will add links for you in the video description, and we do appreciate when you use those. You can get it from Cricut if you've got the Cricut access. You do get discounts on some of the accessories. They are on sale at the time of making this video, and we'll make sure you put links in the description for those. We'll also add some other options for you, plus the Michaels shop online with free shipping, or the shop online and collect in store. And if you do use the links, thank you in advance. We really do appreciate it. Okay, so that's kind of what the Easy Press does. It's a large heat source. It goes up to 400 degrees. I'm going to show you how they operate. You also can get the Easy Press mats. They come in the three sizes of the three Easy Presses. There's a large one down below here as well. And these go underneath. They reflect the heat perfectly. I really do recommend getting the mats. You can use a towel and whatnot, but I think they're a really good investment. And you'll find you get the best results if you use the appropriate mat. You can also get a storage case, which you'll see on your screen now. I don't have the storage cases yet. I'm still saving up. And I should mention that I bought everything you see on the table. Cricut didn't send me any of this. I have accumulated it over time, kind of buying one thing at a time. But I love my Cricut items, and I think they're absolutely amazing. Okay, so that's kind of a summary. Now, what do you use the Easy Press for? So you can use it with your infusible ink, you can use it with your heat transfer vinyl, also makes an awesome iron for pressing when you're sewing, lots and lots of different reasons. They all come with this tray underneath, so when you're using it, it's not going to burn your surface, it's not going to cause any issues, and it is nice to just have somewhere to put it down while you're working, and that is included in the box. It also comes with a dust bag, and as I said, there is a nice hard carrying case that you can get to go with it, which I will get over time with mine. So how do they work? Let's talk about that first of all. The operation is really, really simple. So all you do is you press your on button. You'll see that it just turns on like this. You press your temperature, and then you can press up. Mine's at 400 because I was doing infusible ink the other day, but you can go down to whatever temperature you want it to do. And then you press your timer. Again, you tell it how long you want it to go for. So this one's at 40 seconds because that's what I was doing my fusible ink. And then you wait for it to heat up. And one thing you're going to notice is it heats super, super fast as well. It really doesn't take long. It's already counting up pretty quickly. I'm going to center this on its heat base just because it's going, going to go pretty fast. I'm going to turn the time down just because I want to show you how the timer works as well. So we'll go down to our 15 seconds. But it does work really, really nicely. So it's already up to my 100 degrees. And as I mentioned, the mat is really worth getting as well because you put your surface or whatever on here. There is a great Cricut app as well. We'll do a quick screen record. We'll pop it on the screen. You can see it now. So you just select the material that you want to use, a Cricut material. You select whatever substrate you're using. So say, for instance, here we're using the new infusible paper. We're using the tote bag. Here it will show me what temperature I want my easy press to be, how long I'm going to use my substrate for, and then it's going to tell me what my sandwich is. So it tells me where I want my easy press mat to be, where I want my butcher paper, my transfer, and then, you know, my iron and everything else. So it's really, really useful to bookmark that guide, and we'll make sure there's a link in the description for you as well, so you can bookmark that as well. I find those things really, really useful. So that kind of covers those things. Now let's talk about size. So previously, I would always have said that this middle size was perfect. I never, ever really got my big one out. And whenever somebody asked me, well, what size EasyPress should I buy? I'd always go, oh, just get the middle one. Like, the original size is perfect. You never need anything else. I think that's perfect for everyone. Until infusible ink came out. And somebody warned me of this. I mean, I have had all three sizes because of work purposes. And the mini one is sometimes handy because you don't want to take up lots of space. And somebody said to me, well, as soon as infusible ink comes out, you're not going to want that mini one. You're going to want the huge one. And I was like, yeah, okay, I'll get my big one out occasionally. Maybe if I want to do a t-shirt. Well, I have to say they were right. I get my big one out probably 90% out of the time now. I've been doing lots of experiments with infusible ink. Every time I do a t-shirt, every time I do a tote bag, I get my Cricut Easy Press out. And it's the big one. I have to say the big one is great. It's not hugely heavy. I mean, I can pick it up with one hand. You can see it's not bad to pick up with one hand. So if I was gonna buy one now, knowing that infusible ink is here and knowing that there are lots more fun things coming out with infusible ink and the heat technologies and things with Cricut, I would say get the big one. That might not be right for your craft room. I mean, do whatever is right for you and your crafting. You can, of course, use the medium or the small, and you can just put it down, and then when you've done your 40 seconds, you lift it up, move it over. That will work for you as well. But if it's in your budget and it works for you, definitely now that we have infusible ink, I would say go for the largest size. If you can, budget, space, all of those kinds of things. In my opinion, you will be thankful that you did that. Okay, so this one is nearly up to temperature. When it gets to temperature, it's going to beep at you. So you're going to hear a beep in a minute, which I find a really handy little thing that it does, just to say, hey, I'm here and I'm ready to go. So you're going to hear that beep in a second. I'll also talk about this mini one, because I find this one is really great when I'm sewing as a particular little press. And you can see it also has its nice little mat here. Again, if you're doing a project and you don't have a bigger one, you just go one, wait for it however long it is, you move it, you go down again. Don't slide, particularly with the infusible ink, because you'll get movement in that ink. Make sure you lift and push down. And it does have a handle. So if it says to apply pressure, you can hold down as well, which is a really nice feature on there. And you still have all the same buttons no matter what size of easy press you go with. They have a nice thick heat resistant cord. You hear there, it beeped on me. So you have a heat resistant cord, so you don't have to worry if it gets caught on something. So once it's done that, you'll see your Cricut button also goes green. And then you just press that. Once you've put it on your surface, it counts down, it gives you a visual. And again, it's going to beep when it gets to the end. So I only did 15 seconds. So this in theory would be on my infusible ink. It's going to count down. So it lets me know that it's finished. So they're really, really handy. And I think they're perfect for the home user. Great maybe if you're making things for Etsy or for craft fairs. Maybe you're making things for schools. So many different options and so easy to use. It does lose heat after maybe 5-10 minutes of sitting there, but it'll bring itself back up to temperature. Again, it'll beep at you. It does tell you if it's losing heat. You can see there's a little screen on there. It might go down to 365, and then it'll tell you once it's got back to its 375. If you need to change the temperature, say for instance you now want to go to 400 because you're doing something else, press the thermometer, press up, press your thermometer, and now you can see it's counting back up and it'll go to the 400. So they're really easy to use. As I say, if you want to work with infusible ink, I do recommend getting the large size. If you're just working with HTV, the mid-size is probably perfect. Unless you're doing lots of t-shirts and things, then again, the large size is probably the one you want to go with. But here is everything to do with the Easy Press. The mats are a definite must, and you will get much better results. I used to use a towel, and then I bought the mat, and I was like, oh, I get much better results. Cut down my heat time. I didn't have to reheat anything. I had much nicer edges and things, and a lot less lifting on my projects too. So I hope you found this review useful. As always, links are in the video description for you. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. My Easy Press is now up to temperature again. And then when you're done, of course, I can just press off and it cools down. Leave it to the side. You've got that nice tray that it sits in as well for safety. So don't forget to hit that subscribe button and ring the bell for our daily videos, tips, tricks, tutorials, or maybe something a little bit different like this. If you have a request for a video, leave it in the comments below. I would love to know what size of Easy Press you have or you're considering, of course. And give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video and hit that join button to be part of the Hedgehog Hollow community. So much fun, so many money-saving tips. We would love to see you there. And I will see you again tomorrow for another video. But in the meantime, happy crafting. Bye.